So let's try to solve one problem in this video now. So you're given a sequence of n numbers. We want to find the k largest numbers. So if you have space to store these numbers, then we already know how to do it. You can call the find rank function with k as the parameter. It will return a pivot, and all the elements to the right of pivot will be the k largest numbers. But how do you solve this problem if the number of numbers that are given to us is a very large number? Maybe I am given 1 billion numbers and I want to find, let's say, 1000 largest numbers among them. I don't have enough space to store this 1 billion numbers. So how do I deal with this situation? So we will see the answer to this question in this video. So in this problem, so we are given n numbers. And we are given a k which is smaller than n. So we want to find k largest numbers. Okay. Let's say that m is the amount of space that we can use. That's the computer that it has. We know that it's about 10^6. If the number of numbers that are given to me is smaller than m, then what we can do is that we can store all the numbers in an array of size n. We have to basically find the kth largest number. When you find the kth largest number, then this will partition and return a k, and all the numbers to the right of k, these are all the numbers which are the k largest numbers. So what you have to just call is the find rank function. It will return a k. After that, from k plus 1 to n minus 1, you print all the numbers. There will be exactly k numbers which are bigger than E of k. These are the numbers which are the k largest numbers. That's the answer. So if you can afford an order n space, this is an order n time algorithm, but this is this requires order n space. Let's say consider a case where there is a n is 10 to the power 9, right? So you have 1 crore numbers that are given to you. This you can think of it as a, let's say that you work for a bank, and this could be the transactions that are happening over a period of time. You get a stream of data, so this is the amount of transactions that the people are doing. But at any point of time, let's say that you want to keep track of the, let's say, the 1000 the biggest transactions in terms of the value. Okay, so you are not interested in storing all the values, maybe that's not required. At any point of time, so you are asked to give the 1000 costliest operations, so you should be able to see. So we can't apply this algorithm because I don't want to store everything, because I don't have a computer which can store 10 to the power 9 numbers. So what I do is that I can do the following. I can take an array of size 2k, which is about 10 to the power 6. Okay, then the first 2k numbers that I am going to read, I will store in these numbers, in this array of size 2 to the power k. Then I will find the median, that is the k largest numbers. Out of these 2k numbers, the k largest numbers will be on the right hand side. So the numbers on the left hand side are not the candidates. So I will read another block of k numbers from the given sequence and overwrite the first k numbers, and then again call the median function to find the median, and repeat this process. Okay, so let me repeat the algorithm. First read the 2k numbers and store it in an array of size 2k, find the median. Only the numbers at the right of the median are the candidates for the kth largest number. The numbers to the left of it are not the candidates for the kth largest number. So what I do is that I read another k chunk of numbers and overwrite the left hand side number. Again apply the median. So that will give a median. So these are not the candidates. Again I keep reading the numbers that I have seen so far, and keep writing on the left hand side. If I see a number which is, so this is the pivot, I'll use the, so the median is the pivot here. If I see a number which is smaller than the pivot, then that cannot be in the collection. That cannot be among the k largest numbers, because I already have k numbers here which are greater than the pivot. If I see a number which is smaller than the pivot, then that cannot be among the final k largest numbers. So if the number that I am seeing is smaller than the pivot, I ignore it. I will store it in the left hand side of the array only if the number that I am getting is bigger than the pivot. So once I have written k numbers to the left of it, I again partition it and get a pivot here, which is the middle, and continue this algorithm till I read all the n numbers. So at the end of this algorithm, so I again apply and find the median, the kth largest number in the array of size 2k, and whatever I get a pivot number here, which is the kth one. So the last k numbers are the k largest numbers. Okay, so let's try to see how many times I have to apply median. So I have taken a size of the array is 2k. So what I do is that so in order to find median once, this requires 40k time. And since the how many number of times do I say every time when I read the first time I read a chunk of 2k and then apply the median for the first time. Next time I will ignore all the numbers which are smaller than the pivot. I will only store the numbers which are bigger than the pivot to the left of it, and then apply the so if I divide this into blocks of k's, there will be at most n by k number of blocks, right? So I may have to apply the median function only n by k number of times, at most n by k number of times. So the total complexity of this algorithm is order k into n by k. Okay, so which is essentially order n. So this particular algorithm uses only order k amount of space, but the running time of this algorithm is order n. So so in general, since we can use a array of size order n, so I'm trying to generalize this, so maybe finding the median every time may be too costly. So what we will do is that we will declare an array of size m, and my assumption is that m is greater than k. So, right, so m is the total amount of the largest array that I can declare. I declare this array, I first read the first m numbers and store it in this array. After that, so I am interested in a location, so these are the k largest numbers. Okay, so I am interested in the kth largest number, but when I do the partition, right, so the doing partition is easy compared to finding the kth largest number, because I may have to apply partition function several number of times. So when I do the partition, if the partition actually happens on the left hand side, I know that none of these numbers can be the the candidates for the kth largest number, because the rank of this is greater than k. Okay, see, if when I do the partition, I get a pivot. If the rank of the pivot is greater than k, then I can start overwriting all these numbers with the incoming numbers. If the partition happens to be on the right hand side, then the rank is smaller than k. In that case, I again partition on the left hand side. So what I did, even if k is 100, I can take an array of size 10 to the power 6, which is m. After that, I do the partition. If the partition, when I do the partition, you basically get a partition with respect to your pivot. If the rank of the pivot is smaller than k, then I again partition on the left hand side. If the partition is, if the pivot is greater than, if the rank of the pivot is greater than k, that means that the partition is happening to the left of k here, then I can start overwriting all the numbers that I am going to see to the left of the pivot. So I read the next numbers and fill this left part, again keep partitioning. Right, so if I see a number which is smaller than the pivot, I can ignore it. I need to store this number to the left of the pivot only if it is greater than the pivot. After I do that, again I do the partition. If the pivot rank is greater than k, I continue partitioning on the left hand side. But if I partition on the left hand side, that the pivot is greater than the k, rank of the pivot is greater than k, then I start overwriting the numbers that I see which are all greater than the pivot, and start writing on the left hand side. When the array overflows, again I do the partition and continue. So when I order n time, so the analysis is very similar to what we have seen earlier. So if it is k, then it will be order n by k, but here actually I am finding the median n by k number of times, but here I am not explicitly looking at the median. So if I do one partition, I will be able to write some numbers. So on average, we don't need to do more than n by k number of partitions. So and each partition only takes order k time. So the total amount of time that you end up spending is order n, and this can be done in order m using order m space, right? So this is time. So if m is about 10 to the power 6 and my k is about 1000 or 10 to the power 4, so this algorithm that I just described will run much faster than starting with an array and taking array of size 2k and then working with the median. So I want all of you to write a code for it and check that. So this is very efficient in practice. So in this video we have seen that in order k time and order k space and order n time, you can find the k largest numbers in a sequence of n numbers. Okay, so we have also said that if k is small, like 10 to the power 3 or 10 to the power 4, then you can start with an bigger array. So order m space algorithm, which is also linear. So and we have also said that if you can use more space, that is order m space instead of 2k space, the algorithm in general will run much faster than using just the k space. I want all of you to try to convert this into a code and see whether these algorithms can be implemented and they show some differences in real life.